Use headphones for best experience. Say thank you so much for your super nice comments on my videos. It's so fun and nice to read them. I really appreciate that you write comments to my videos. So thank you so much. Also, I would like to tell you that there's a new album here on music streaming platforms such as Spotify, Apple Music. So it's this one, Loose Sketching Sounds, Drawing 22 Maps, where you can see all the maps here as separate tracks. So you can listen to my content here as well, as well as watching on YouTube. Today I would like to draw another map, and I will try to draw the map from the game Forza Horizon 4. And I got quite a lot of requests about doing this map, and I hadn't played this game or seen anything about it, but I did some research and found it really interesting because this map is based on Great Britain. So it's a game version, or a shrinked down version somehow, on Great Britain. So it was really fun to read about places, locations in Great Britain and Scotland. Yeah, Scotland is part of Great Britain, of course. I will start by doing some rough sketch as usual. this will do for now. And let's start using some markers. I'll start with the coast and lakes. So here, I guess, we have the North Sea to the east. And I'll continue to draw the rivers, or if it's like more like creeks here, in the same color. This is a body of water, it's the Derwent Reservoir. That you can find in the Peak District, the middle of England, in Derbyshire. Lake District National Park. I think I'll go on with the Derwent Water, one of the largest lakes. It's located to the north of the Lake District. So even though these names resemble each other, the Derwent Reservoir and the Derwent Water, they're actually located in quite far from each other. But not here, not in Forza Horizons, Britain. It's also an island here in the middle of the lake. And then we have another creek here. Mm-hmm. leading all the way to the sea. Another one here, and a mountain lake here, I guess. And another creek. Leading to the Firth of Forth. And this body of water here, or this inlet, is supposed to be the Firth of Forth, north of Edinburgh. Because Edinburgh is located here, the biggest city of Forza Horizon 4. Some stream here as well. Here's another lake. I suppose it is a lake. You can't see the whole shape of it on the map, at least not the map I've been looking at. And I think it could be the Windermere Lake, in also in the Lake District in Cumbria. Yeah, the Derwent Water is also in Cumbria, because yeah, the Lake District is in that county, northwestern England. This could also be the Lake Tarnhouse, probably. Tarnhouse is located here on this map, and in England it is located a bit to the west of Ambleside. And Ambleside is located here, so it could also be Tarnhouse. I'm not sure about this. Here's another lake. See if I can add blue color in the lakes, or if it doesn't make sense. It's just almost the same color as the background, probably. Actually, it doesn't matter if I do that, so I'll stop. Next, what should I add? I think it's time for the roads, because this is a racing video game. So the roads are, of course, very important. See if I can use this correction pen, white out pen, same as I use in the intro. So we have some roundabouts here. between those. Different shapes of this. And I will draw two lanes because, yeah, to show you that this is the motorway. Yellow for all the other roads. And I'll start here. Maybe I could zoom in a bit so you can see more in detail what I'm doing. So this place is called Astmore. Bamburgh Castle is a very old castle in Northumberland, in northeastern England, by the coast. Here we have a lighthouse. We're in Edinburgh, Scotland. Here's a train station, Edinburgh. And of course there are a lot of roads in this city, biggest city shown here. This is Arthur's Seat, which you can find also in Edinburgh. It's an ancient volcano, the main peak of the group of hills in Edinburgh, Holyrood Park. Okay, there are actually some roads here, I can draw them since I did that by mistake. something like that. And I will draw some roads here in the center of Edinburgh as well. Because when you draw a lot of streets and blocks like this, it really looks like a city, I think. So this is a park, this square here. This is Edinburgh Castle here, located here. Of Edinburgh, we have three bridges that you can see. If you're on if you're on a point where you have a good view over the area, you can see these bridges. It's the fourth bridge, the old railroad bridge, and also the fourth road bridge, and Queen's Ferry crossing. So we have Queen's Ferry should be located here. If we move on to the west, we have the main road leading to Derwent Water. We follow that road in this direction. We will eventually reach Broadway. Broadway that is based on the village with the same name in Cotswolds in Worcestershire. So now we're in southern England, in the Cotswolds, grasslands, close to southern Wales. And yeah, I think Broadway is actually in the county of Worcestershire. I found these names a bit difficult to pronounce. Worcestershire and Gloucestershire. Yeah, I think I've seen on a map that it's on the very southeastern tip of the county. So now we're back here in Astmore. District, Northern England. Here's the Tarn House. Here is one of the biggest villages on this map, Ambleside. And Ambleside in England is a village in Cumbria, the Lake District, just by the Windermere Lake, just north of it. So that's why I think this could be Windermere, this lake here. At the Derwent Mansion. And Mortimer Gardens, I'm not sure if it's based on something in England, but I read that it could be inspired by something. It could be inspired by the Roman ruins in Virginia Water near Windsor Great Park. So Virginia Water, it's in Surrey, south of London, but very close to London. But actually it's in the very northern part of the county of Surrey. And here we will continue. The road will follow this this creek here, this river or creek. And here we have a beautiful view, the Glenfinnan Viaduct. This curved, more than 100 years old railway viaduct in Highlands, Scotland. It's in an area called the Lough Aber, the Western Highlands. The road follows the creek like this to Glen Rannoch. Croftdale Farm is located here, and here we're back at this road here. this is how the map looks so far. We have the bridges here, we have Edinburgh, motorway, some important roads, and Ambleside, the Lake District, Cotswolds, Highlands. Here we have some really high mountains, peaks, I guess it's the Highlands of Scotland. And I will continue to draw some roads. See if I can mention some areas at the same time. We have two roads following the Derwent Reservoir, one on the western side, one on the eastern side. So then we follow this creek here in Ashbrook. We have a bridge over the water here. So you will reach the west, the eastern side of the lake. Here we have the most forested areas of the map, Lakehurst Forest here. The Huntsman's Lodge. Here to the motorway in Edinburgh, and we have a road here through the Moorhead Wind Farm area. Connects here to the motorway, and in the opposite direction we will reach Derwent Water. And on this road, a bit more to the south, if we follow this road, we will end up here on the western side of the reservoir. And we have another bridge. Crossing here in the middle of the lake. This road will lead to Thatch Corner. We also have a lot of roads here between Astmore and Arthur's Seat and Moorhead Wind Farm areas. There's some roads, connecting roads as well. Kickers Adventure Park. And this road here, it passes the Standing Stone. To add some features on this map. Before I forget it, so here we have the Standing Stones. Standing stones all around Britain and Scotland. So I don't think they are based on a specific location, but for example in Dumfries in Galloway, southern Scotland, or in Argyll in western Scotland, and on the islands, the Shetland Islands, Orkney Islands, I think you can find these prehistoric monuments. We also have the Uffington White Horse here, really cool feature on this map. So this is a prehistoric hill figure located in Oxfordshire actually. So it's deep trenches filled with the crushed white chalk. So now we're in Oxfordshire, between London and Bristol, approximately in the middle of southern England. See if I can draw my version of the shape of the horse here. Would be cool to include it on the map. That's the White Horse. And here are the Standing Stones. Here also we have the windmill, Broadway windmill. So I would like to add the lighthouse. And I need to complete the Broadway with some more roads, so you can see it's a village here. Horizon Festival site. And continues here to the Kingfisher's cottage. Here's over this forest. The state quarry here. And I would like to do the same in Ambleside. A few more roads here. This road passing the sunflower meadows. Now you can see it's a village here. And I will add a road here to the north. So you can reach the Lake Lodge residence north of the Torrent Water. A bit like the outer circle of the Lakehurst forest. And it connects to this road here. And we have a road following this creek as well. And this is a mountainous area. Here we have a trail, the Glenrannoch Trail. We have the Croftdale Farm. I would like to add this Glenfinnan Viaduct. Since I'm drawing a railway, I would also like to somehow point out the train station in Edinburgh. And also the Edinburgh Castle. castle. And another thing I have forgot is the Great Ridge. It's located here, Moorhead Wind Farm area. So these are basically a lot of fields, farming, all this area. And here we have the Great Ridge. Interesting feature. It's located in Derbyshire in England. So it's also in the Peak District National Park, where we also had the Derwent Reservoir. But this is a ridge that's separating the vales of Edale and Castleton, and it's a path that runs along the length of the ridge here, so 3 kilometers approximately. And we also have some more roads here. One road that passes the Fairlawn Manor. So now the map is already quite detailed, and I'm thinking about what to add next. I think I'll add some mountains and forests now. So we have some mountains here to the west. But I think the highest mountains are located here to the north. And also Arthur's Seat in Edinburgh. It's like a mountain. Lakehurst's forest, as I mentioned before. It's also a darker green, but it's not, this color is not very visible on this paper. And we have some forested areas here as well, around Derwent Reservoir. South of this creek as well. So, some more forest here. The southern border. Border of the area. Near in Torn House as well. Also here around Edinburgh. Add some And these are more like farm fields, farmland. And I leave that as it is. Just no symbols for that. Add some red, and what I'm gonna point out with the red marker are some of the houses. So we have a thatch corner here somewhere. Castleview Road, south of Edinburgh. And we have Glen Rannoch, this area. Here we have the Croftdale Farm. By Derwent Water, we have Lake Lodge to the north, Derwent Mansion, to the west, in the middle of Lakehurst Forest, we have the Huntsman. We have the express rail yard. Don't think I mentioned that before. And here, close to Derwent Reservoir, we have Kingsfisher Cottage. Gables. And in Ambleside we have Sunflower Meadows. And I've already pointed out the castles, Bamburgh and Edinburgh Castle. I would like to label some locations, not all of all those that I've mentioned, but some areas would be nice to write down the names of. And then I'll zoom in a bit. So I'll start here with Astmore. Moorhead Wind cursed forest. Ambleside. Reservoir. And yeah, I think that's it. Somehow show you that this is the North Sea, so that this is actually coast and not a river or something. See if I can use a crayon for that. It's almost invisible. This one instead. Not sure if this makes any difference. Thought this one would be a more light blue. Now I found a more light blue, I think. This make any difference to this very blue background that I prepared? What about this one? Yeah, this one is better. And I'll use the same pattern here for the legs. So, I think there we have it. The Forza Horizon 4 map. There's just one more thing I would like to show you before I end this video. I have talked quite a lot about the places in Great Britain that corresponds to some of the places in the Forza Horizon 4 map. So for example, I mentioned the Lochaber Highlands, where you can find the Glenfinnan Viaduct, and that's here in Highlands, Scotland. And I mentioned Argyll and Dumfries. And Galloway, where you could, for example, find the standing stones. And I mentioned Edinburgh, of course, the Firth of Forth, this water inlet here. And Bamburgh, it's located here, the very northern parts of England, close to the Scottish border, in Northumberland. And of course the Lake District in Cumbria, where we have Ambleside, Derwentwater, and Windermere, a lot of places here, the national park, big national park, and close to Manchester we have the Peak District National Park, where you can find the Great Ridge, and also the Derwent Reservoir. So it's here, basically in the center of the island. And I have mentioned Cotswolds. Southwest, and here you can find Broadway. Here somewhere. And Oxfordshire is here, around Oxford. Here you can find the Uffington White Horse. And I also mentioned Virginia Water, close to London. Surrey, I'm not sure. When I say it, it almost sounds like I'm saying sorry. That I have found. Maybe there are more locations on the Forza Horizon 4 map that correspond to something in Great Britain. But thank you so much for watching and for requesting this map. Hope you enjoyed this video. And that you found it interesting, relaxing. So, take care. See you soon.